All right, you're the lucky winner with the flu prize. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Can the flu kill you? Should you get the flu vaccine? Will the flu vaccine give me the flu? And is the flu shot dangerous? Don't worry, we will go over all of that today. Hi, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm a real-life board-certified emergency medicine physician. My mission is to make these videos for you and answer all your urgent medical questions and clear up myths about various diseases and illnesses. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Just kidding. We are officially heading into flu season, and that's why today we're going to talk about influenza and the flu vaccine. Because, well, you can't really talk about one without the other. So, what is influenza? Well, it is often called the flu for short. Flu is a contagious respiratory illness caused by influenza viruses that infect your nose, throat, and sometimes your lungs. It can cause mild to severe illnesses, and in some cases, influenza can lead to death. In 2018, the CDC created a report that stated that 8% of the US population gets sick from the flu each season, which translates into influenza killing about 80,000 people in the 2017 to 2018 season, according to the figures released by the CDC Control and Prevention Division, which is up from previous years. So what are the symptoms of flu? Fever, although not everybody who gets the flu will have a fever. Cough, runny nose or stuffy nose, body aches or muscle aches, headaches, fatigue, and some people will also experience vomiting and diarrhea, although more commonly in children than adults. Also, very important to note, influenza is different from the common cold in that influenza hits abruptly right away, even though they are both viruses. Who are at high risk from the complications of the flu? Anybody can get the flu, even healthy people. And serious problems related to flu can happen at any age, but you should take extra precautions if you are over the age of 65 or if you have certain chronic medical conditions such as asthma, diabetes, or heart disease, or if you're a pregnant woman or a child under the age of 5. You might be wondering how the flu is transmitted, or how can you get it? Well, brace yourself if you're squeamish. You're probably not gonna like what I'm about to say. Most experts believe that the flu virus can spread mainly by tiny droplets that are made when people with the flu cough, sneeze, or talk. Yep, these droplets can land in the mouths and the noses of other people who are nearby. In other circumstances, a person might get the flu by touching a surface or an object that the flu virus is on, and then they might touch their own mouth or nose or even possible their eyes. Ugh. So how long is someone contagious for? People with the flu are most contagious in the first 3 to 4 days after the illness begins. Although, you may be able to infect others beginning one day prior to you showing symptoms and up to 5 to 7 days after you became sick. So you rolled around in someone else's flu droplets and you think you have the flu. What do you do? Well, if you can, make a little trip to see your primary care doctor or to the urgent care. That's where a doctor can properly diagnose you by that good old nasal swab up the nose trick. It's very difficult to distinguish the flu from other viral or bacterial respiratory illnesses based on symptoms alone. That's why it's very important to get a proper diagnosis. All right, you're the lucky winner with the flu prize. Or in all seriousness, what do you do if you've officially been diagnosed with the flu? Treat it, of course. There are prescription medications out there called antiviral drugs. These antiviral medications can be used to treat the flu illness, and you can only get them if you have a prescription from your primary care doctor or healthcare provider. A very important note, antiviral drugs are different from antibiotics. A lot of people get that mixed up. And that's why I've written a little poem for you. If you're sick with the flu, only antivirals will work for you. When treatment is started within 2 days of becoming sick, antiviral drugs can reduce fever and flu symptoms and shorten the time that you're sick by about 1 day. So don't rely on that alone. So how do we prevent seasonal flu? Or can we? The CDC recommends everyday prevention actions like staying away from people who are sick, covering coughs and sneezes, and frequent hand washes to help slow down the spread of germs that cause respiratory illnesses like the flu. And all being said, the best way to prevent the flu is by getting a flu vaccine every year. All right, I know what you were thinking. To vaccinate or not to vaccinate, that is the question. Without going into the whole vaccine debate, I will say this. Physicians want the best for all patients and take an oath to first do no harm. It's our medical standard of care in the United States to use vaccines, and I believe as a physician that the use of vaccines and their benefits outweigh the negatives. Okay, I'll get off my soapbox for now. Here are the facts. Flu vaccinations reduce the risk of flu illnesses by 40 to 60% among overall population during the seasons when the circulating flu viruses are well matched in the flu vaccine, especially for those who are immune compromised. During the 6 influenza seasons from 2010 to 2016, influenza vaccination prevented an estimated 1.6 to 7.6 million illnesses. So, can you get the flu from the flu vaccine? No. A flu vaccine cannot cause the flu illness. The virus in the flu shot is killed or inactivated, so you cannot get the flu from the flu shot. But it can trigger an immune response in your body that makes you experience mild symptoms such as body aches, muscle aches, or low-grade fevers. When is the flu season? Influenza virus is typically circulated in the United States annually, most commonly from the late fall to early spring. So if you choose to get the flu vaccine this year, the CDC recommends that everybody 6 months of age and older get the flu vaccine by the end of October. So that's been a little influenza talk with me, Dr. Wagner. I hope I've cleared up some questions you may have had around the flu and have helped you get a better understanding about this highly contagious infectious disease. Make sure you leave me a comment on what medical topics that you'd like me to break down. Also, please hit the like button so I can keep making medical videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. Stay healthy, my friends.